All right, today we have a 2005 Subaru Outback 2.5, and this is the 4AT Phase 2. Phase 1, which was back probably in around like 98, is very similar to the RE4 RO1A unit. That one had a band, this does not have a band. These have all individual solenoids, where the older unit had the solenoid pack like the early Pathfinder. So what's going on with this is you can see there's new lines here. So the lines were all rotted out and the fluid leaked out and the guy kept driving it. So after the shop had put the lines in it, it still had a delay or a slip or a chatter on pull away. So we're going to open this up and see if we possibly find the low clutch damaged. But I didn't drive it, but the manager drove it and said there was definitely a problem. So we're going to take these lines off. I had to loosen these lines to get the diff out. And this has a spin-on filter, which the Phase 1 unit, or the original unit, does not. And it has a couple of sensors here. It has three sensors. We're all going to take it off and just kind of hang everything down here. Then we're going to proceed to take the tail off, which is where the all-wheel drive is, to get the gears out to, you know, knock this section out where the pump is, because it's going to come out with the pinion here as well. All right, so I guess I'll get a little closer here and we'll start taking this thing apart. I had the pan down and again, all individual solenoids, so I kind of, you know, took some snapshots with my phone. I drew a road map so I know where everything goes when I put it back. A lot of ground wires and all the individual solenoids versus a solenoid pack just with one connector or two connectors. All right, so I'll get a little closer and we'll take everything out on the outside. Then we're going to take the tail off and then possibly the valve body, make sure nothing's in the way when I'm knocking the shaft through. All right, so I'm going to get a little closer and we'll get started. All right, so again, I did have these lines loose. I'm just going to continue and take these off. There should be, it's like the old one, should be a ball and spring in here, but you know, the old one didn't have the spin-on filter, so I'm not really sure what we're going to find here. Okay, there is a spring. So this is obviously like a one-way, you know, check ball in here. So here's the spring, goes in there, and then we're going to take the check ball out. Let me get my magnet. All right, so as far as these Phase 2 units go, this actually is my first one tearing down. There's the check wall. Don't want to lose that. All right, so now the spin-on filter. And I got everything moving a little bit to try to make it go a little quicker. I guess like cooler return. The switch off already. So I wanted to tip this thing up to get the pan down, so I didn't want to crush anything. All right, so now we're going to take the sensors out. Let's see how that goes. I did was crack the bolt loose. When I was doing the pan, one bolt broke, so I'm gonna have to drill that out. This thing is pretty rusty on the outside. Okay, the sensor, input sensor. And then this last one is, I guess it's something for the four-wheel drive or for the transfer clutch. Disconnect the harness, we can take all the wires out of the picture. All right, so now we're going to take this off here. This is a nice section. Should be a drum with a set of clutches in the back. All right, that looks like 12. We got a couple ones that are stubborn. So, should be it. Now to try to get this thing apart, it's gonna be fun. These dowels are all rusted. Extension. Right here is the transfer clutch. You got a couple of rings that right here. You got a bearing. You know, actually sits there like that. So you know, on some of these, and you got another bearing that goes in here. On some of these Subarus, say you have a chatter. When you're turning, you know, a lot of these older ones, the solenoid would go bad. But say you have a chatter. All right, this must be some kind of a seal here. Again, this is my first one, so it must lube, go right here and lube that. You know, send lube there maybe to a bearing. You look under the hood, like say you got this thing chattering on the turn, and you look under the hood, there's a little spot where a fuse can go, and it would say front wheel drive. So when you put, there's no fuse in it, but when you put the fuse in, it shuts the four wheel drive off, and you can see if the problem is gone. on the early ones, the transfer clutch solenoid used to be in this section, and we used to do a lot of them. So we would put the fuse in, drive the car. If the problem went away, then we know that that solenoid or this clutch is no good, so we pull the back of the unit off and fix it up, put it back in. And most of the time it was the solenoid. Okay, so we got to take this nut off here. This normally would come out, but that doesn't really have to come out. All right, so let me find my socket for that. Actually, should have had that ready. And then we're gonna zip that off. And then I think what we're gonna do is take the valve body down, because I wanna get everything out of the way. And then we'll knock, take the bolts out of here and knock it through. And we'll get to the gear train and then just tear it down. It's really about it. So just give me one second. Let me get my socket ready. All right. Had a couple of pins here, so I knocked that off. Let me just turn my light back on. Looks like there's a couple of, you know, small bolt connectors under the pan, and then all the individual solenoids. Fairly clean. They don't really put a gasket on this from the factory, so it's all like silicone. But I do believe the gasket comes in the overhaul kit. All right, now the filter is a 3-volt filter. This tube out, and then we're going to unplug the solenoids, and it looks like possibly all the outside bolts. There really is no manual or anything on this. I had asked my Transtar rep.
like we have a one for these. Let me get this out of the way. Okay. Looks like we got a temp sensor here we're gonna take out. Small bolt connector, and then all the individual solenoids and ground wires. Ground wires, there's one here, one here, one here, here. So we got about five of those. So I marked all with those one as well. And I'm sure there's gonna be accumulators, more than likely, under here. So I guess we'll just start disconnecting and taking this out. All right, so to continue, let's unplug this here. I'm going to probably wind up doing this valve body. So I did, again, you know, I took a picture, I drew a roadmap. Sensor. Alright, so let's see if we can get this valve body off. Now it just looks like all the outside ones here. Looks like that's going to be it, because the valve body's moving already. Case seal. This will come in the overhaul kit. Alright, so now I'm going to take these bolts out and see if we can't bang this thing through and take the, you know, that's the pump stator and stuff like that. Here is the seal for the pump drive, which is still attached onto the converter. I can actually show you that too. And this should come out. Yeah, that'll come out. All right, so let me take these out here. That would be a 14. The other one, the phase one, had accumulators just like the, just like the Pathfinder unit does. All right, so let's see if we can get this moving. See if we can get that gear off. Sometimes they have threaded holes in here. You could put a puller on, but this really doesn't have that. Let's try this way. Then the whole unit will just come apart. Alright, so I want to find the next thing to try to do is get these wires out. So I can start flipping this thing around. All right, so a little bit of a pain to get this started. These things, everything gets very brittle and I really want to try not to break them. So I used my heat gun and I heated it up and I actually got it moving. You know, I heated around here, I heated up the tab, so I actually got it moving, but very, very tight. None of the tabs are broken. Here is the harness. We'll get this thing out of here, side. But I think really what's holding this is these dowels. Well, this one I can't really get. I'd like to see if I can move that dowel a little bit. All That got it. Bearing out of the case. Slide this whole thing out here. The gasket is going to be changed. This off and look at the pump. All right, so first we have the reverse and high clutch drum. We'll open this shortly. Let's get the rest of this apart. Here's the hub and sun gear. All right, so now that normally the band would be, this is the, should be the second brake. It looks like there's an anti-rattle clip here. Not bad. No, but this is, like I said, the first one that I did, so these, you know, I guess they really don't go big that much. There's a funky looking bottom plate. Alright, we're gonna take this anti-rattle clip out. Alright. That goes right in the center. Once I get this thing apart, I'll get a better shot of that. Alright, line it. Alright, so here is the low clutch. This is what I want to see. How bad that is. kind of still resembles as the main planet or front planet, sun here, rear planet. If something was up with this. These are burnt. Not bad, but they are burnt. Stator. All right, so what we got to do now is take that snap ring out that holds the return springs down for the second brake and get the piston out. And then the low reverse clutch, and then take the bolts out of the back, and that's really about it. We'll take a look at the drums. Thinner screwdriver. Go. Okay. Snap ring. Return springs. Here's the piston. Of course, we're going to switch the O-rings in there. Okay. Now we're going to take the low reverse clutch out, and there is another, as I wanted to look for, another anti-rattle clutch. So let's get rattle clips for the low reverse. And now we just got to take the bolts out of the back.
got one left. I don't want this whole thing to cool down here, so let me lay it down here. Get the last one out. This is, you know, bearing rides here, a sprag rides here, and the low clutch drum rides there, and this bearing, as I said before, went there. Okay. There is the return spring. And it looks like a molded piston. Take this apart, see if I can see anything, because it did have a problem on the pull away. I'm gonna take the pump apart and look at all the clutches. All right, so give me a few and I will be right back. All right, so here's the hub for the reverse clutch. You got a bearing here. Here's the hub for the high clutch. These look like they all have molded pistons in them. And these look good, but again, I'd like to do a banner kit. And a dished steel. Now for the high clutch. Alright, yeah, he's got some little dark. You can still see the writing on him, but definitely got to be changed. Burnt up. I actually never drove. I don't know how bad the slip was, but what we did say is when the gas station had called, and I still feel that there's a problem, you know, first question he asked, since it was leaking, hey, is it full of fluid? So, you know, when you check transmission fluid with the dipstick and say it shows higher, you know, high on one side and low on the other side, you always go with the lower side. That is the true reading. So he was getting readings like that. That's why he wasn't 100% sure. So we had said just dump an extra quart in and see what happens. And he called back and said it's still doing the same thing. So at that point, there's probably something internal. And we picked the car up and again, you know, the manager did feel something when he was driving it. All right, so let's get these bolts out. All
trains to do. Actually has gears in it. The other pump on the phase one is vanes, just like the Pathfinder. You got a dowel here for lineup, dowel here, which is great. All right, so you got a lip here, so you know that gear is going to face down. And we have any identifying marks here? We do not. Let's take this out. Don't have any identifying marks there either. But the pump looks good. Overall, the unit's really not that bad a shape. I did order a banner kit, and I'm hoping it comes with pistons. You know what, let's take a look at this transfer clutch real quick. I think we even had him look for the all-wheel drive under the hood and eliminate the four-wheel drive. I'm pretty sure Tina told him to do that as well. Yeah, these things are pretty good shape. Molded pistons in here as well. I believe the transfer clutches do come in the banner kit. All right, so let's just take a look at the valve body. I don't know the function of the solenoids. I didn't get into that or which ones they are, but it even doesn't look like a bad valve body to open. You know, I mean, it could be an EPC solenoid or shift solenoids in lockup, temp sensor here. So overall, it really, you know, doesn't look that bad. I've done plenty of the other ones, but this is my first one of the phase two. So, the, you know, difference is we got molded pistons, the band was eliminated, now it's a 2-4 brake because it sits in the case. And we got one drum for the high and reverse clutch, where before there were two drums. And the reverse clutch drum is where the band would ride, but since they eliminated the band, they have that, you know, they have the one drum now for the two. But overall, not too bad. I'm gonna go check my parts. Actually, I'm gonna go get them now. And let's see what the banner kit looks like. I'll give you a shot of the banner kit. So just give me a few minutes. I'll be right back. I gotta go outside and get the parts. All right, so here is the converter with the pump drive. And this will come out. This usually held in like with a clip, you just gotta squeeze the clip or push the clip in. You know, this tab's sticking up and that'll pop right out. Just put it into the new one. And I got the banner kit, it's just the kit and clutches, no pistons. And I just actually looked at the work order and it shows a flare on the 1-2 and on the 2-3. This is the banner kit here. Here is this, and here is the, you know, all the clutches that you get. So now I just gotta do some research, possibly on a piston kit, because they're molded pistons, and I certainly like to change those. And I'm thinking this is an EPC solenoid, which also I'm going to change. All right, so I guess that's about it for this 05 Subaru Outback. This is the 4AT Phase 2, and again, according to what the complaint is, a flare on a 1-2, flare on a 2-3, we did find some burnt clutches, but really nothing crazy, so definitely going to go through this valve body, change a couple of these solenoids, and I'm going to inquire about a piston kit for the, you know, for the molded pistons. Pump looks in good shape. And I guess that's really about it. So I thank you guys for watching. Have a great day. And we'll see you next one.